One of the easiest topics, extremely important from examination point of view, is internal reconstruction. Easy, but extremely important. Last four examinations of new scheme of CA intermediate, two times there was amalgamation question, two times there was internal reconstruction. Compared to amalgamation, internal reconstruction is the easiest of all. Easiest of all. So, let us learn it with the very basic, beautiful provisions, and then let us work out some questions. What do you mean by internal reconstruction? Restructuring the financials, restructuring the financial statement internally. AS 14 and internal reconstruction, no connection. As I said in the introductory class of amalgamation classes, I said AS 14, there should be a concept of minimum one liquidation. Here, internal reconstruction means you are doing restructuring yourself. You don't close the company, you don't open any company. An existing company does some restructuring by self. Now, for this, we need to have very basic knowledge of the either first class of CA Foundation or somewhere in CPT if you learned or PUC as the case may be. All of you know the balance sheet. The traditional balance sheet, if I prepare a T-shaped, all asset account shows which balance? Debit balance. All liabilities account shows which balance?
Credit balance.
Trust me, if this much of knowledge if you have, little bit of extra 2 points theory, internal reconstruction over, done, 20 marks, Kirti, pass, amana, pasa, deanta. We will be able to enjoy it. Agreed, Mati? Yeah,
yes, sir.
Fine. So, all asset account shows which balance?
Debit balance.
But increase, what should I do?
Debit.
Debit.
The mathematics. Debit is equal to debit. Plus debit. Is equal to plus. All liabilities account shows which balance?
Credit balance.
If I increase, what should I do?
Credit.
As simple as that. So, the extra 2 points of theory, what you should remember is extremely important. Point number one. This company doesn't get closed. However, assuming the name of the company is A Limited, if the company underwent internal reconstruction, they may have to suffix the word and reduced will be written within the bracket, if and only if the court so orders. Sir, I'm confused, sir. I agree with your confusion. I like it. Now, normally this internal reconstruction is carried out by loss-making companies, not compulsorily. Normally, this internal reconstruction is carried out by whom? Loss-making companies. Normally. Sometimes, maybe some other reason they would have done it. So, since it is a loss-making company, public, be aware of this company. This company underwent internal reconstruction. Here, now it is a beautified balance sheet. Earlier, it had huge losses. Be careful before you make an investment, before you do anything with this company. Beware of this company. So as a caution, if the court wanted to give it to the public, then only court may suggest to use the word and reduced. That means the moment you see a newspaper ad, A Limited within the bracket and reduced, going for a public issue, you should be extra careful. This was a loss-making company earlier. However, I said normally. What do you mean by normally? Not always. There may be some other reasons where share capital, which was a 10 lakh shares are rupees 10 each. We had 100 lakh. Now we make it as 1 lakh shares are rupees 100 each. So 10 rupees share has been, the face value has been increased to 100. There will be 10 share, merge karke, you made it as 1 share. Or ulta, as of we had a share of rupees 100, Kirti, we have made it as 100 shares are rupees 1 each. That is also called internal reconstruction. Any change you do in the balance sheet is called internal reconstruction. So just because I changed the face value, why should I call it as a loss-making company? It was not a loss-making company. It was a profit-making company. So the court may not suggest you to use the word and reduced. Are you understanding, my dear friends?
Yes, sir.
So first point. Second point is the fixed assets which have been written off. Very important. I'm talking only about fixed assets, which we now call it as a PPE. Technically, it should include PPE as well as intangible assets. PPE accounting standard?
10.
AS 10.
And India's, you don't know, intermediate level is not required. Okay, we have 16. India's 16 dealing with that. And coming to the intangible assets. Accounting standard?
26.
So all these assets which are written off need to be shown for next 5 years. Need to be shown for next 5 years compulsory. Like somewhere, if you remember in Schedule 3, there are some 5 year condition.
Shares issue farther than cash.
You remember something like that?
Yes, sir.
Here also, whenever the fixed assets have been written off, fixed assets basically today means tangible covered under PPE, intangible covered under intangible itself. It has to be shown for how many years?
5 years.
So, in the process of internal reconstruction, if a return of plant and machinery show how much is the amount which you written off for next 5 years. If a return of something as a part of inventory need not be written off. As I keep telling in accounts, more is never less in account. No, sir, I want to disclose even inventory return off. You show, I don't have a problem. The accountant said always say that disclose more and more. If you want to show current asset, I don't have a problem. But compulsory requirement, two conditions. Condition number one, the name and reduced may be suffixed, that is written after that. As of now, Kirti's name is Kirti Anandu. Kirti is her name. Anandu is a suffix. Tomorrow, she marries Gundappa. So, her name changes to Kirti Gundappa. Correct, Kirti?
Yes.
That is the meaning of a suffix. Whereas, prefix is what comes before. Miss Kirti, after the marriage, will become?
Mrs.
Kirti. So, Miss will become Mrs. So, that is the prefix what we put. So, prefix is before, suffix is after. So, the name what we are talking about here is A Limited, within the bracket you may have tried AND, A-N-D, not a symbol, A-N-D reduced, if and only if the court so orders. Fixed asset written off has to be shown for compulsory for how many years?
5 years.
So, now, don't interchange this. Next class, what do you say? Sir, fixed asset written off has to be shown if court so order and reduced 5 years. I didn't say that. The name is concerned, court ka, what do you call, haath hai. Court will say, if the name has been to be changed or suffixed, I will suggest how many years as told by court. Court would have said 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, whatever. But fixed as a written off, whether court orders, whether high court orders, supreme court orders, your family court orders, doesn't matter. Your food court doesn't matter. Fixed as a written off must be shown for how many years?
5 years.
5 years. Brilliant. This is about the theoretical aspect. Now, let us come back to that balance sheet. Asset side is what? Debit balance.
Debit balance.
So, in the process of internal reconstruction, anything increases or anything decreases, any profit or loss, how do I account for the same? Two RMRs. You have got two approaches. See, Ganesh? You have got two approaches. Approach number one is called capital reduction approach. Any profit or loss transferred to an account called capital reduction account. In Canada, what we call it as. Anything and everything should go to an account called capital reduction account. Something like a realization account or something like a revaluation account. A newly opened account, any profit, credit karo, any loss, debit karo. Samajh mein aa raha hai?
Yes, sir.
Oh, brilliant. So, you have to transfer to capital reduction account. Whereas, so there... At the end, whatever the balance left out, what to do with that balance? Now, this is one more important theory. You must use that balance of the capital reduction account for writing of the following items in the following order only. See what happens. The internal reconstruction is normally carried out by loss-making companies. So, unnecessarily, the assets values have been showing at a higher value. Shareholders value, they want to reduce it. So what happens? Take an example. Share capital is 100 lakh. Accumulated loss is 80 lakh. Another 20 lakh, if the loss is added, it will become a sick company. Your net worth is almost equal to accumulated losses. That's why before it is closed down, before it becomes fully sick, losses, let us revive it so that the shareholder, the company will call for a meeting of the shareholders. Sir, if you continue like this, company will be closed tomorrow. They say, no. We'll forego something. We'll call the meeting of the debenture holders. We say, sir, if you continue like this, we are paying 24% debenture interest. If you continue like this, tomorrow company will be closed. So what to do? So they say, no, don't worry. Reduce our interest. So something like that when they agree. whether shareholders agrees, debenture holders agrees, creditors agree, whatever agree, anything, any profit or any loss, transferred to what initially?
Capital reduction account.
At the end, whatever the balance in the capital reduction account, we have to beautify the balance sheet. How to beautify the balance sheet? On the asset side, all of you listening?
Yes, sir.
Okay. On the asset side, in a traditional format, I'm trying to say, obviously in a company accounts today, P&L account debit balance is shown on liability side itself under reserves and surplus in the bracket. So for a traditional understanding, P&L account debit balance is the worst asset what you can have in the balance sheet. P&L account, if you lost it, is the worst asset. It's not an asset. Tomorrow I want to say, sir, I want to sell my building. Fine. I want to sell my P&L account debit balance. They say you are cranky. Who will purchase? Are you ready to purchase? I will sell. Okay. I will start a company and make a loss. I'll sell it to you. Will you purchase that P&L account debit balance?
No, sir.
No. Unless you are cranky. So, first remove that. Hata do. Kya hata do? P&L account debit balance. Second one, your fictitious assets, which we used to call it as a missing expenditure earlier. Fictitious assets like preliminary expenses, underwriting commission, deferred revenue expenditure. They are also unwanted, unnecessary assets which are appearing in the way. Usko bhi nikalo, remove it. Afterwards, goodwill. If it is a loss-making company, look at the beauty of the stupidity. So, on the left-hand side, you are saying you are having a negative balance in the P&L. Athava, on the asset side only you say P&L account debit balance. But I have a goodwill, Saratha. How can a loss-making company have a goodwill here? Technically, continuously. Initial period is fine. See, there are some exceptions to that. Like a startup companies, etc. Fine. But general discussion, if you are a loss-making company, how can you have a goodwill? It is like an oxymoron. Okay, happily married. Either you are happy or you are married. Both cannot go hand in hand, okay? And so, happily married nahi ho sakta hai. Okay, either you are happy or you are married. Both cannot happen. It is something like myself and my girlfriend were happy for last 10 years. We are happy for last 10 years. Then we got married. There is a statement in your statement, not my case, just a statement. In other words, here also, if you have goodwill, okay, it's meaningless, remove. So, I'm giving with the logic. So, it should come in the same order. First item. P&L account debit balance.
P&L debit balance.
It teaches assets.
It teaches assets.
Then any other assets, if the value has come down, if it has been impaired, we call it an impairment as
per
year. They will give you, that's one issue, do it. For example, they may, any other asset can be tangible or intangible. So plant and machinery value has come down, patent value come down, you reduce it. So finally, whatever the balance left out in the capital reduction account, transferred to a reserve called a capital return. Because it is a profit arising under capital transaction.
Capital transaction.
If you go through the accounting aspect, initially any profit you make, mainly transfer to an account called capital reduction. Organization account or reconstruction account. In the question, if they say open reconstruction account, all are same, identical triplets names. Okay, everything is same. Whatever the profit comes, that profit has to be utilized for what? Writing of the assets in the following order only. First one?
P&L debit balance.
Third one?
Goodwill.
Tangible assets. Sharanya, as may be given. If they give it, you do it. No, sir, I don't like this. I want to remove. You can't do that. They will be giving you in the question, you'll remove it. Understood, my dear friends?
Yes, sir.
So this is the first approach. The second approach is, do you have a Caesar at home?
Yes, sir.
And do paste. So what I had, look at me. What I had a statement like this capital reduction account, having, let us say, 10 line item, I will take a Caesar, beech mein kaat do. This is something different, this is something different. This is called shared surrender approach. Oh, sir, I'm confused. I know you are confused. I like it. What does it mean? Under shared surrender approach, we open two accounts for the same activity. Any transaction with the shareholders, route it through an account called shared surrender account. If the shareholders forgo 10 lakh, credit to shared surrender account. Any transaction with the non-shareholder, continue with the capital reduction account. So, there are two accounts which was similar to capital reduction account, two accounts. First one is called share surrender account. Any transaction with the shareholders routed through what?
Share surrender account.
And ultimately, whatever the balance left out in the share surrender account, transfer it to capital reduction
account. Capital reduction account
continue in the same manner. That means all the transactions related to the shareholders will be routed through
share surrender account.
Profit left out there will be transferred to capital reduction account. Any profit related to the non-shareholders will be routed through capital reduction account. Continue the same process. At the end, those items to be written off the same order. P&L account, debit balance, fictitious asset, goodwill.
Tangible and capital reserve.
Understood?
So yes, sir.
How do I know whether the capital reduction or share surrender? Very simple approach. If the question specifically asks or there is a clue about the term surrendered, they say the shares were surrendered. If they use that word, that means it's a share surrender account. Otherwise, it is always the first approach, capital reduction account approach. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
The second point in share surrender, which normally everybody does a mistake, okay, is whenever you convert, let's say Kirti is a shareholder. She surrenders 10 lakh to me. I'm a company. There's a profit to me. I take it. She had a preference share. I convert these preference shares into equity shares. Then I issue to a new shareholder called, applicant called Yashaswini. Now, there are three activities happening. Kirti surrendering to me, 10 lakh, profit to me, enjoy. I pass an entry. I issue these shares to new prospective shareholders, say Yashaswini, Ganesh, Jayant, whoever it may be, pass the entry. In between Beechka, you are converting this preference share certificate into equity share certificate. There is no entry. It is a very loose explanation if you want. It is something like a reprinting the certificate. Athava, you had a preference share certificate, usko whitener lagado, and make it an equity share. A very loose explanation. It is not the way they do it. I'm just telling. When you just change the format of the certificate, will there be an entry? Answer is
yes.
Normally, people get confused here. So preference shares are converted to equity shares, then they reissue. Here, only under internal reconstruction, you have to pass the entry for that equity shares when it is issued to the prospective shareholder, not when it is converted into equity shares or converted to any other security. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
In sum and substance, one of the easiest topic out you can score. Every alternative examination, you can expect these questions. I'll be doing all these questions a little later. Internal reconstruction and AS-14, sambandh nahi hai, sambandham ledu, connection nahi hai, connection is not there, connection e.g. So internal reconstruction is an independent topic. Whenever the company wants to do the restructuring of the financials, balance sheet, P&L account, udhar kuch karna hai, if they do anything, that is what's called internal reconstruction. Internal reconstruction, there are two theory aspects you must remember. The words and reduced may be suffixed to the name, suffixed to the after the name. A limited within the bracket and if and only if courts orders. Fixed asset written off should be compulsory shown for next 5 years.
Five years.
Compulsory, no option. There are two approaches for internal reconstruction. Capital reduction account approach, share surrender approach. Under capital reduction approach, any profit, maybe shareholders are foregoing something, fixed asset, upward revalue, any profit initially transferred to an account called capital reduction account, also called
reorganization.
Profit has to be utilized for writing of the following items compulsory in the following order, which are the four items.
P&L, debit balance,
tangible.
Next, coming to the share surrender approach. So you have to take that capitalization account, take a scissor, cut karo. Each way. Whenever there is a share-related transaction, route it to an account called share surrender account. Balance is transferred to capital reduction account.
Capital reduction.
From there, continue the same process what I said. Ultimately, the balance of the capital reduction account is transferred to
capital reserve account.
And on special entry, share surrender, when there is a conversion of one security form into another security form, no entry.
No entry.
Extremely important point, you should note. And in the examination, do share surrender approach if and only if they specifically ask or question uses the word somewhere.
Surrender.
Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Is that easy?
Yes, sir.
Easy, 20 marks to cakewalk. Share surrender, internal recursion question comes, you have to write dance. Okay, wow. So 20 marks, aage bolke. That is the way you should be approaching this topic. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now start reading someone.
Internal reconstruction. When a company decides to reconstruct its financial statement without liquidation.
Underline without liquidation. We are not closing the company. All of you have the material in your hand. You can see.
Then such a process is called internal reconstruction. Normally loss-making company go for internal reconstruction. In other words,
underline the word normally, not always. So even a profit making company, they want to do some restructure of their capital, fine, but normally. So normally she is my girlfriend, that is okay. She is always my wife, that is the way you should say. If you interchange word, dangerous. Normally she is my girlfriend, it's okay. Semester scheme no affiliate chalta hai, whereas normally she is my wife andre mukha muti odtaak bidtara. Okay, she is always my wife. She is normally my girlfriend. Both do not meet. Continue.
In other words, internal reconstruction means reorganizing or restructuring the capital, share or loan of a company and bringing the asset to its real or market value.
Yeah, you should bring it to the real value. There is a concept called impairment also later. We'll discuss that impairment under AS 28. Sharanya, yavdo? Account standard number?
AS 28.
Continue.
If they are shown in the books at an unnecessary high value.
Yeah.
The two important points to be noted
extremely
in this
extremely important.
Are,
extremely important. Yeah. First and only one, this much theory is more than enough for your internal reconstruction life. Nothing is required. Next.
First one, the word and reduce should be suffixed to the name of the company if and only if the court so orders. Second one, fixed asset written off in the course of internal reconstruction scheme should be compulsorily shown for the next 5 years.
Yeah, so please do not interchange. And reduce the court if so orders. Court if so orders. And fixed asset written off. Fixed asset today means PP and intangible asset. Compulsorily, underline the word compulsorily for how many years?
5 years.
5 years.
5 years. Shares issued for consideration other than cash. In the amalgamation chapter also I told you. Should be shown for how many years?
5 years.
5 years.
In the absence of the specific information, use the word and reduce.
Yeah. In the examination, sir, if they're not given, end up under the simple again, use the word and reduce. A limited and reduce. LBM and reduced. Goobard and reduced.
Approaches to internal reconstruction. First one, capital reduction account approach. Second one, share surrender account approach. First one, capital reduction account approach. Any profit or loss in the course of internal reconstruction will be routed through capital reduction account or reorganization account.
Reorganization account, reconstruction account, whatever the name they give you in the question.
The ultimate balance in such account shall be utilized to write off the following in the order of preference.
In the order, only in this order. You cannot change this. Illa sir, I want to interchange the orders. You can't.
First one, P&L account debit balance. Second one, miscellaneous expenditure to be extent not written off.
That is called fictitious assets. Today we don't call it a miscellaneous expenditure. There is no such head itself. It is called fictitious assets. Like a underwriting commission, preliminary expense, brokerage, etc. on the issue. All those will come there. Yeah.
Third one, goodwill. Fourth one, tangible asset and other intangible asset if and only given in the problem. The ultimate balance in such account shall be transferred to capital reserve account.
Ultimately, where should you transfer?
Capital reserve account.
Second one, share surrender account approach. The scheme is divided into two parts. A, share surrender account. All the transactions related to share, cancellation or fresh issue is routed through share surrender
account.
So, I
said anything related to share, whether it is a cancellation, fresh issue, anything related to share should route through what? Share surrender account. Don't use the word share suspense. It is not share suspense. It is share surrender account. Continue.
The ultimate balance in such amount shall be transferred to capital reduction account. State surrender account is similar to capital reduction account.
I said it is Caesar approach, cut approach. So upar wala share related cut karo, profit balance transfer to what you call capital. It is like a trading P&L account. Trading account separately, P&L account. First approach me everything together we did. Today only one P&L account is suffice. Capital reduction account. Second one is trading account alag se karo, P&L account alag se karo with the gross profit being carried. So easy.
Yes, sir.
Continue.
Capital reduction account continues the process as explained in point 1 above. Note, no journal entry should be passed for converting share surrender account into equity share or preference share. Entry should be passed for such share at the time of issue.
Extremely important point. Make important mark. Red ink, green ink. Make important mark. Make a box. Because you will be passing one extra entry. Very good, Ganesh. Extra entry when it is not required. It is not required. Yeah, continue.
Example, equity shareholder surrendered rupees 400 lakh share capital, pass the entry. Out of the above,
equity shareholder surrendered 400 lakh share capital. What do you do? Pass the entry because hamare ko profit hai. So, aha, enjoy. Next.
Out of the above, rupees 300 lakh converted into 12% preference share. No entry.
There is no entry. It is almost like a certificate name change. Yeah.
Such preference shares are issued to creditors, pass the entry.
When you're converting, some printing station expense may be there. That will go to the printing station account. But related to share surrender, share capital account, it won't come. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Share surrender involves three arrow marks.
Come down. There's a beautiful further analysis. Yeah, come down. Yeah. So the same things where there's a confusion possible is the beauty of CAPS. We keep on giving it again and again, right? Again and again. We are obsessed with the consistency, I say, okay? And chart approach is the best approach because we are going to be chartered accountants. Yeah. Wherever there's a confusion, write again from different angle. Your life will become beautiful.
Share surrender involves three arrow marks. Surrender of shares by an shareholder, if it is the profit to the company and then pass the journal entry.
Perfect.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Second one, conversion of such surrender share into equity or preference share of different denominations like printing share certificate. No journal entry.
Yeah, the conversion. There is no entry. I repeated this because the 8 out of 10 times students will have a mood. Sir, I want to pass the entry. Control your mood. No entry. Entry? No, nahi hai. Ledu. Continue.
Issue of shares out of such share surrender, pass the entry.
Yeah, that you have to pass the entry. All of you clear about it?
Yes, sir.
Easy?
Yes, sir.
Simple?
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Okay. So if you just stick to this theory, trust me, any question about internal reconstruction, you'll be able to do it. Okay. One additional point I want to tell you before we get to the problem about the preference dividend. Be extremely careful. Be careful. That comes in a problem later. Now, if it is a cumulative preference share, the preference dividend which was not paid for the current year, may be paid in the next year. That is the meaning of cumulative, it accumulates. Take an example, in a balance sheet, there is 100 lakh, 10% preference share capital. How much?
100 lakh, 10% preference share capital.
Like online, offline, there is no difference in caps. Everything same. Okay, so everything, you should respond. Be active, be alert, sit straight. That's it, okay. So 100 lakh, 10% preference share capital. First year, dividend. Case number one, you have paid the dividend. Kel katam, full stop. You have paid. Second year, you could not pay for whatever reason. Whatever reason, okay. Even if you have profit, you would not have paid because that profit may be required for your expansion purpose. Liquidity reasons you may have. So, second year, you have not paid the dividend. Third year also, you have not paid the dividend. Fourth year also, you have not paid the dividend. That means 10 lakh, 10 lakh, 10 lakh, 30 lakh gets accumulated. How much, Baba?
30 lakh.
And each year, you'll be showing this as a notes to account outside the balance sheet. This is called contingent liability.
Contingent.
As per ES 29. A liability which may or may not arise.
May not arise.
Because writing exam in May or November, it will definitely arise. Okay. So, a liability which may or may not arise in the future. So, it uncertain future event that the term used there. So, let us assume in the fifth year. So, first year you have paid, I said. Second, third, fourth, all the three years, okay. Accumulated preference dividend is how much? 30 lakh.
30 lakh. 30 lakh.
30 lakh. So in the fifth year, if the company go for internal reconstruction, case number one, preference shareholders forgo this 30 lakh dividend. Preference shareholder forgo this 30 lakh. They forgo that the adjustment given. What is the entry? Anyone? If the preference shareholder forgo this preference,
no entry, sir. It will not be shown as contingent liability.
No entry. Excellent. Extraordinary. Very good. No entry because it is off balance sheet item. The question of cancelling something to come into picture if it already exists. If I have 50 rupees in my pocket, I can spend 50 rupees. If I don't have 50 rupees, how can I spend 50 rupees? Look at someone and say, "Hey, din nachke mana mari tigiti na." You will keep on laughing.
Idreta.
So very beautiful answer. Excellent answer. So it is not appearing within the balance sheet. That's why there is no entry. Let us take second example. Out of 30 lakh, they forgo 20 lakh. Out of 30 lakh, how much they forgo?
20 lakh.
And 10 lakh rupees dividend, whatever it may be, okay, we are supposed to pay by cash or whatever, by check, okay, online transfer. What is the entry?
Payment for 10 lakh.
Who wants to answer?
Preference shareholders
account debit to bank account.
That is not the right answer. See, you use the right logic in the first stage. I knew you'll get confused. I knew it. That's why I just taken an exam. First logic you correctly applied. Second logic you have not applied the logic. Second time. Why? Sanja, what will be the entry? If the preference dividend, 30 lakh was in arrears, first 3 years you are not paid. So fourth year or the fifth year you are not paying. You said no entry. Now extend the logic. In the second option, 20 lakh you are not paying. That means no entry.
Yes, sir. No entry.
The 10 lakh rupees you are paying from your pocket now, which is not appearing earlier. So under internal reconstruction, where should you debit that?
Share surrender.
Why you are going by share surrender? You can go by capital reduction account. It's not related to the shares. Okay. So which account we are going by? Normal understanding, capital reduction account. That means this is one special adjustment again. Preference dividend which is in arrears. If you are not at all going to pay, no entry because it is not appearing within the balance sheet. How can you cancel? How can you cancel which doesn't exist? Whereas out of 30 lakh, if you are paying 10 lakh, it is a loss for you. Balance sheet may not here. Any loss, where should I debit? I said, Sanjay.
Capital reduction account.
And you are paying two bank accounts. Something like realization expenses when you pay. Realization account to bank. Something like consignment, expenditure borrowed by the consignor. Consignment account debit to bank. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So easy?
Yes, sir.
So beautiful?
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much.